The American Academy of Pediatrics recommends solely breastfeeding for the first 6 months of life and then introducing solids at that point, but continuing to breastfeed up and through the first year of life. The World Health Organization recommends up and through the second year of life are what's mutually accepted by mother and child. Ultimately, the right length of time to breastfeed for is what works for you and your baby. Some women are not producing enough milk, so there are many ways to help increase your milk supply. The best way is using your baby to stimulate more production. The more the baby's breastfeeding, the more that your baby is stimulating more milk production. However, if you have to give a bottle because you're after that feeding because you're not producing enough milk, if you pump at that point as well, you're telling your body, thanks to what you gave me, the baby got what I had, but I need a little bit more. So by pumping after each feeding, it's going to help stimulate more production. Other ways to help increase your milk supply is sometimes just changing some of the things that you're eating. Caffeine can decrease your milk supply, but foods that can help increase milk supply by incorporating them into your diet, oatmeal, whole grain foods, malt, making sure you're eating and drinking to thirst and hunger, and continuing to take your prenatal vitamins. Some women leak, some women don't. It's not a sign of more or less milk. It's just how your body deals with your milk supply. There are nursing pads, washable nursing pads, as well as disposable nursing pads that you can get at any pharmacy or baby supply store that can help stop you from leaking through layers and layers of clothing. Some women will leak in the beginning and then not at the end. Someone will leak the entire breastfeeding experience. But again, it's not something you need to worry about. It's not a sign of more or less milk. But just know the first time, if you haven't been leaking, the first time you leave your baby to go out or go out to work, if you think about your baby, it can very easily stimulate a letdown and you can start leaking. So be prepared. Carry a set of nursing pads in your bag or wear a pair out just in case that happens so you don't have to be left in an embarrassed situation.
When you're looking for organic foods, you have to really be careful when you're reading the packages and the labels, specifically with your fruits and vegetables. Every fruit and vegetable has a five-digit code. Your organic fruits and vegetables will start with the number 9. So that'll sort of help you through the grocery store matrix a little bit.
To have a private lactation consultant come into your home, the prices can vary state to state and from person to person. However, the long-term cost savings of having someone come in and help you get off to a good start breastfeeding-wise is astronomical. It's a lifelong savings because not only is it just the bottles, you know, the savings on the cost of the bottles, savings on the cost of the formula, but you have your overall health savings. There's less visits to your pediatrician. Therefore, if you're a working mom, it's less time missed from work to bring the child to the pediatrician, less co-pays, and less medical expenses overall. If by chance you have to take a medication when you're breastfeeding, there are many resources to find out if it's a safe medication with breastfeeding. Most medications are safe. However, when you read the little inserts inside medications or you ask your pharmacist, oftentimes it says if you're breastfeeding or pregnant, consult your physician. So rather safe than sorry, they tell you don't. But most medications are safe. You can simply find the information out by asking a lactation consultant or going on a website called toxnet.gov. If you click on the link for LactMed, L-A-C-T-M-E-D, you could put any medication, including over-the-counter medications, and find out the safety of the medication. It will give you the American Academy of Pediatric recommendations, as well as information from any research that's been done in relation to that medication.
It's very common for your baby to fall asleep while feeding. They love to be next to you, they feel calm, they feel comforted, they love to eat. So a lot of times your infant's gonna fall asleep before the bottle's finished, before the feeding is finished. It's important to wake the baby up because feeding time, it's work time. It's good for the babies to finish their full feeding. This way they could stretch out a little bit longer before the next feeding. So there are different ways to wake your baby up during feedings. One of the ways is to stop the feeding. You could burp the baby. You could take off some of the baby's clothing so they don't feel so comfortable. You could change their diaper. These are different ways, but you do want to make sure that the baby does not fall asleep in the middle of a feeding. They will also associate a lot of times feeding with sleeping. And the only way they're going to fall asleep is to eat. And that's not such a good practice. So you do want to differentiate feeding and sleeping with your infant.
She falls asleep often, like if she's not really that hungry, she will fall asleep very soon and she doesn't eat more than 1 ounce. And I have to make sure she wakes up.
When you feed a breastfed baby a bottle, you want to sit them upright on your lap and make sure they're supported. You can support their neck and their upper shoulders. You want to hold the bottle parallel with the floor so that just enough of the nipple is covered with the milk so that they're not sucking in air. So that when you feed the bottle, they have a little bit more control over the flow and it's not being poured down them. So if you lay the baby back, gravity's pushing that milk down and giving them a faster flow. With breastfeeding, they have control over that flow. So you want to kind of simulate what they're doing at the breast with the bottle the best that you can. So sit them upright and hold the bottle parallel with the floor just enough to cover the nipple so that they have more control and they have to work to suck out the milk instead of it just sucking and pouring down their throat because they're in that reclined position.